Hello to everyone. How are you? This is Joanna, and today I want to share with you some items that I have. As you know, I went out to Walmart and Target. I stopped in at TJ Maxx, and I have a Bath and Body Works box that my soaps came in. So I'm going to share with you what I got. This right here was a little snack that I got, a little dollar bag of cotton candy. They didn't have any candies in the aisle where I was. I was kind of looking for something like those little fruit chews. They didn't have any, just chips and cotton candy. So this is what I got. This is the little bag that I picked up from TJ Maxx. I will not be keeping this bag. These were all that they had, so I don't know if they are not going to be selling the reusable bags for a moment again. I hope not. But I had two bags when I left from Walmart. It was my intent to go to Target first, but I found the majority of what I wanted at Walmart. And like y'all know, I've said I hate Walmart, but I do like it for bath stuff and cleaning products and things like that. I just don't really get any groceries from there. So the first place that I went to that I want to share with you, or the first thing I'm going to share with you, because it's not the first place I went, is Ulta. And at Ulta, I picked up this little Hemp's banana, sugared banana and vanilla blossom. And I got this because of the bar soap that I got, that I don't know if I'm saying it right, Passion Bahamas, whatever, that has a banana type note in the mist. So I wanted to get this for that. So let's see, I have it here. Yeah, okay, the Passion Fruit Banana Flower. I do have this set, but I just felt like this lotion and this mist and that bar of soap would go good together just for something quick as far as something small. Now, a lot of what I purchased today, and I'm going to try to make sure that I name everybody, because certain things that I found, I got because of certain people. Now, one of the things that I got is, y'all know that I watch Ask Whitney, and I love her channel. She is a makeup channel. She is the one that does a lot of the nude lip looks and sent me making a list every time I watch her. I started watching her because of the Wahala 2 palette that I have, and she did a lip combo with various lip pencils, and one of the glosses that she used was called Sis. Well, this time I was watching Taylor Anise, and I think that she was swatching the news from Juvia's Place, but I think she was doing it just for the sake of making a video for nude glosses, because a lot of people have swatched that already, but I hadn't paid attention to it. So she mentioned this one called Caramel Rose, and I loved it. And so I went ahead and got it, and it's not that far off from Sis, but it is deeper than Sis, and I had to get this because I love those colors of gloss. So that's what I got from Ulta there. Now, it's just $13. Then they had these eyebrow pencils, and they didn't have the tester open where you could try it out. They had one. Let me see. These had names on them. Let me see if I can see. Because one of them had the slanted tip, and then I opted for the micro brow pencil right there. And the other one had that slanted tip. Now, the shade that I got was Chocolate Mousse. And I do believe it is their darkest one. I don't know. But for $6, I figured it wouldn't really hurt, you know, just to get a brow pencil. And let me see. What am I doing? Because I'm trying to do this one-handed. So let me see. I don't know what I'm doing here, guys. Okay, here's the tip, and it does go up or down, so you're not stuck with it up if you accidentally roll it up too far. And it is those micro types. So I figured I'd try it out for $6, because a lot of times I'm just flitting around, you know, not going anywhere. I don't want to use my good one, but I do need another Anastasia one. And I think that's all that I got from Ulta. So then I went into TJ Maxx and I saw this. Now, we all know that I didn't need this, but I smelt it and I liked it. It was a nice light peach scent, but to me it smells more along the lines of the way that the peach smells when you get close to the peach pit. Like, it was a light enough, mild enough scent. And I don't have any peach dove. Now, the one that I'm looking out for is that lemon one that a lot of people show. But then I saw these, and just in case, this was $6.99. So I do plan on utilizing that now. And I don't know how well that'll go with the body polish that Dove makes, because that one's peach mango. But still, I think that that'll be a nice summer wash. So the next thing that I got, I saw these, and y'all already know, young Mrs. Ashley, I hear her talking about exfoliating gloves. Then I heard Miss Anna talk about exfoliating gloves. She got, I think, 10 pairs from Amazon. So I figured I'd try these out. And also, I have heard just Kayla Michelle talk about some. I think she may have found some for a dollar somewhere. I'm at one of the dollar stores. But I figured I'd try these out. Now, this is not something that I will stick with per se, just because I think if I were younger, I would. But I just wanted to try them out for curiosity's sake. And these were $3.99 at TJ Maxx. And then this purchase was because of shopping and sense. I remember seeing her talk about these, and she liked them so much that she went back and got as many as she could find. And I just happened to be on the little rack thing that they have sitting there, I guess when they're either going to stock or restock or move things around. And I saw this sitting there, and I thought of her, so I went ahead and got it. And I looked at her video while in store to make sure it was the right one. So I'm going to try to hold this so you can try to read or pause where you want to. And I need to do the same thing for that Dove wash. But it did smell really, really nice. And then, of course, from Target, of course, y'all know I got a Cherry Coke. Did not eat that with, or did not drink that with the cotton candy. So I've been curious about this Method hand soap. Y'all may or may not have heard me mention that. And it is called Sweet Water. I have not smelled this, but I'm hoping that it'll smell nice and fresh. So I went ahead and got it. It was just $3. But what I wanted from Target specifically was I wanted to try this lotion. And I tried to do a little video like y'all do, but everybody was around and near and it was really, really hard. But in that video, I did say that I was going to get all three. I got somewhere where I could be by myself and I ended up smelling them and I was not crazy about them. I did not like the coconut water one. The vanilla shea one reminded me of a Body Ecology vanilla that I had, which I did like at that time. But I have enough because I love vanilla. Not that I won't go back later, but right now I have enough vanilla scents that I need to go through. Now, it was a nice scent, and it smelled a little different to me than the warm vanilla sugar that is compared to, but it wasn't bad. It's just I feel like I have enough vanilla, so I may surface back and get that because some people are saying that this is hard to find. Some are saying they might be getting rid of it. So I will surface back because I think that that vanilla one will be a very nice one to use with any of the vanilla scented bars, whether they be brand name or off. You know what I mean? I thought it was nice, but I really want a pomegranate scent because I'm interested in the bars for the Summer Dove to the wash that I have. And then I'm thinking there is a pomegranate hibiscus one or a pomegranate lemon verbena one, or it's all three, I don't know. And a lot of people are still finding the pomegranate and blue fig bars. Now I love those, and like I said, I may have some around here in a box that I need to find, but I am just interested in pomegranate and lemon scents because I don't have many things in the way of that. So I did get this, and I did end up not getting the other two. But I will go back and probably get that vanilla one. So then I was looking for this, and I had just said that I wish they would make it in a 4-bar pack because this was the soap that I purchased along with the pistachio bars back when I did that. If y'all remember, there was a time right before I got that Alex 9, and I had all these soap bars, and I was just buying soap then to be buying soap. My kids were at home, but I had opened up the drawers one day because I was just showing what was in there, and I had this and the pistachio ones down there, which is how I think I probably boxed them all up because sometimes I was giving soap away, but I do believe that I boxed them all up and I need to find them. So they did have the 4-bar coconut milk pack, which I was very happy about. But now that I see people still finding the pistachio ones, I'm curious about those. And then I wanted to get some raw sugar soap after seeing a lot of people talk about it. I wanted the lemon ones because I don't have any lemon soap. Now, I do have lemon body wash. Both of them, I think, are Bath and Body Works. One of them is the Bright Lemon Snowdrop, and then the other one is that lemon that came out that we couldn't find the counterparts to. Something martini. I don't remember. I'm probably incorrect, but y'all know what I'm talking about. But I do want the lemon scrub because I don't think I have a lemon scrub. So I do want the raw sugar lemon scrub, and I want their aloe and cucumber wash and scrub if I can find that. So I went ahead and got these bars just to have some bars from raw sugar, but I do still want the lemon ones. And I think that's all that I got from Target. So now I'm going to share with you what I got from Walmart. Now, my Walmart purchase, I had broke it up in store into three different things, three different orders, but they were all for me, of course. Now, I went ahead and decided to try this cherry because y'all know that I said I wasn't crazy about it when I was in the store, but I did not dislike it enough not to try it. And I also wanted to see how this would go because y'all know that I have the Bath and Body Works. Is it baked cherry pie? Well, I have the Bath and Body Works set. And usually I will run out of the gel because I have two creams, a couple of lotions. So it stands a good chance I wanted to try this with one of the lotions. But this one is the cherry one. And some people are saying this smells like the fruit stripe gum. I don't get that. But I do know that when we use a product, it's a little different. So I was curious about it. I didn't dislike it enough not to try it. Now, I will not try the other two just because these two are enough. But again, I do still want another lavender one. And I'm going to try to hold this here so you can pause and read if you would like. Hopefully, I don't never know if this helps or not, but I usually like it when people do that so that I can read something. And the next thing I got, y'all know that I had mentioned that Young Miss Ashley had showed the Camilla one, and then I ended up getting the grape seed. When I was on the Target site, I ended up seeing this almond oil one, so I wanted to try this one. And all of these have a very, very light scent. I think the one that she had was specifically for sensitive skin. And I got the grapeseed oil because I like grapeseed oil. But I did want to try a second one. I don't need the other two because y'all know that I wanted all three before I knew about this one. But I wanted to get this one. Now, this cap was loose in the store, so I had to watch it because I started off with a whole lot of stuff and I have different places to go. I went along the strip. I went from Walmart to Burlington. I didn't get anything out of there. And then I went on down to Kohl's. I ended up not going in there. I went to Target and Ulta and TJ Maxx. And they are all on the same strip. I just have to cross a highway where the Target and the Ulta is. So I wanted to definitely try this. And the Pro Oat lotion that Ashley used, I see that and I want to try it. And they finally had the CeraVe SA face wash that she was talking about. They had two of them in Walmart, but they didn't have a price on them. So I looked online. Target supposedly had them for 11 something, but they had none in the store. On the Walmart thing, I couldn't tell if it was the Walmart store or if it was the Walmart, the thing where you order and it has a higher price. It was 19 something, so I'm just going to wait. But I am curious enough to try that because I do have oily skin, and even though I'm older, I still have trouble with breakouts and acne. So I got that wash. So y'all know that I wanted the soap bars. Now, the one that is the regular, I think Epsom salt and eucalyptus comes in a single bar, but this came in four, and that was okay because I wanted this. I'm in the lavender to begin with. So I went ahead and got these to try that out. Then I saw this. I don't know if this has bars. If it does in your area, let me know. But this right here is the Morning Blossom Limited Edition. And I didn't even see the word limited edition. I have a plum one. But I think, yeah, this is purple. Okay, I wasn't trying to do that right there. But it does have a really, really nice and pleasant scent. I did like that about it. And let's see if it says anything on here about the fragrance. Not too much, but I do really, really like this. And then I got these because these are the ones that I like, just any of the Huggies, Aloe, or whatever, because these are stronger and bigger than the FDS. I think if the SDS wipes, if the FDS wipes were this size and this strength, it would be a little bit better. They're small for what they're for, you know what I mean? So these are a lot better to use. So the next thing that I got was another one of these. I already have one, but I know Miss Shaughnessy was looking for this. And I think young Miss Ashley said it wasn't in her area too. We had several of these. I think we had maybe, I don't know how many, but in the little video that I showed, we had a whole row. Now, when I first went, we had two, then we had three, and this time we had a whole row. And then they had another little orange one there. So we got plenty of these. So if either one of those ladies needs one, I have one that I can send. And then a lot of people on here, I think Self-Care Catherine, Young Miss Ashley, Latoya, and several other young ladies, they were showing this. Now, mouth rinse is something I used to get for my kids. The Act and the Crest and all that, the bubble gum one, the ones you squeeze up. I would get into that from time to time. But I don't really use a mouthwash unless I have an awful taste in my mouth or some medicine that I'm taking or something like that. And I usually don't like Stark mint toothpaste anymore because I love the smooth mint Crest coconut toothpaste. I got it back when I got that charcoal one. I haven't used a charcoal one yet, but I love that smooth mint because it's a soft mint. I didn't know that until I used it. A lot of our more popular, you know, been around for a while toothpaste, the Colgate and all that, you know, I don't really like those because I don't like that Stark mint. Back when I was younger, that was all that we had. The alternatives were the Pepsodent, the Close Up, which came in green and red. There was a Cinnamon Crest at one time. They were making flavors. There was a Vanilla, there was AIM, but I've never liked that Stark mint. So I thought I'd give this a try when I saw that there were different flavors of this, and this aloe and cucumber that one of those ladies showed really got me. So I figured I'd try this and see. And then the other thing that I got was, I heard Miss Shaughnessy talking about this. Now, I haven't sprayed it or anything yet. Now, I did spray the Picnic one, that violet colored one. I mess with that every time I'm in Walmart. To me, it reminds me of an Avon fragrance, and I mentioned this to her in a message. It reminds me of Tempo, if anybody remembers that. It also reminds me of the Exclamation fragrance that my daughter liked, that Picnic one. So I don't know, but I want to smell this one because a lot of people are talking about this one and I haven't smelled it at all. This is going to be my first time smelling this one. And it says that it is sparkling pink peonies and warm vanilla and almond. And I usually like things that are almond. But I also am a fan of things that are like sugar scented, pink sugar. So right now, I think it's okay, but I'm going to have to wear it for a while and see. Because it looks like it would be a pink sugar scent, and I'm not getting that from it. Not that it has a smell like pink sugar per se, but I do smell some of the peony. And I also have to keep in mind, guys, that I actually have this on. Even though I put it on this morning, it could be interfering. So I do want to make sure that I like this because I will go back and get the lotion to this. But I don't hate it. I just feel like whatever I've got on is interfering with it. So the next thing that I found that I was so happy to find, and wouldn't you know, Walmart had this and Ulta had this, but I got mine from Walmart because this is one of the ones I've been looking for. So the only one that I don't have that I really, really want is that lemon blueberry tart or whatever the name is, if I'm saying it right. And then someone told me that this was light today, and that's okay because y'all know that I like light things. I tend to wear a lot of my light stuff to work. You know, I don't want to be over fragrant, but a lot of times people would stand near me, guys, before the pandemic, and they would be like, oh my god, you smell so good, and they would just be standing near wherever I was, and I always wondered why, because I couldn't smell it. But at that time, I knew what it was the fabric softener I was using, because if y'all remember, I had said years ago that Downy made the almond fabric softener. People could smell that, so I wouldn't wear too much fragrance, and then once they quit making that, I will tend to wear a lot of my vanilla scents to work, any of my soft coconutty type scents, just those soft scents, because I work in the medical field and I don't want to be too offensive, but I also want some fragrance on. So I wear things that are kind of light. So it doesn't matter that this doesn't smell, but A lot of people are also saying that these particular scrubs smell better in the water. And I would like another one of these because I really do like vanilla. And I don't think, besides my Bath and Body Works scrubs, I would not have a vanilla scrub, I don't believe. But I am going through a couple. And there's a couple of things that I'm going to be using that's going to take precedence over a few things that I need. Like one, I need to finish this. And if you never got this, I feel sorry for you. If you like a nice, plain, fresh scent, guys, they need to bring this back. And they need to call it what it is. Now, the last three things that I got. This was something new that I saw, and y'all know that I have the bubble bath in this. And someone asked me if I plan, or you know how I like the Dove bubble bath. I haven't used it yet, but this is the bubble bath that I plan to get into first. And I plan on using probably one of my unscented bars of soap, because a lot of my coconut bars have other things in them. Like the one that I just got has jasmine in it. And then that one bar that is the vanilla and something, I might try that with it. But for the most part, I'm going to do an unscented bar, that bubble bath, and this. So this is the After Bath Body Whip. Now, I didn't see this the day that I got that bubble bath, but I do want to use these together. Because it's still cold enough to take a bubble bath. And then what I was looking for, y'all already know, was another brown sugar. Now, I had mentioned to some people, and I think I even said in one of them little videos, if you find these and you want these, get them. Like, for example, I had stated that I want to use this one in the wintertime, so I'm buying them up now. Now, I know that I have a good amount of them, so I don't want too many, but I also don't want to miss out. And if I use this like I was using the one, I'd say if you use your scrubs 2 to 3 times a week, some people might use them 4 times, some people might use them every other day, you'll go through them. But I want to try this out because I am going to use one of these now while it's hot. I feel like this one and that plain macadamia rice milk one and the calendula one are good for winter. I feel like that macadamia rice milk one is actually good all year round. And then I feel like the lavender, the pomegranate, the kiwi, and then this one right here are good for the summer. However, you can use a scrub anytime you want. Maybe in the wintertime, you want to have a scent of summer, so you use it. I just say, though, if you want these and you see one somewhere, get one to try. Don't just leave it, because I bought that one that I had, that rice milk one. I know that I would have hauled that with y'all a while ago, like I said, probably a few years ago, maybe even 3. And I had just used it when I got into this apartment in 2021, and I loved it. So I'm very happy these are around. But YouTube and TikTok have these things so popular, they are selling out. So I hope that Dove sees this and knows this and keeps producing these. Because when I went into Walmart today, they had a few more of the brown sugar. They had 2 of these. They had more pomegranate. And all of them have a whole lot of the rice milk one. So I'm definitely going to go back and get some more. But I'm going to start using the kiwi first. I don't hate the kiwi, but I dislike it out of all of the other ones. And that's why it's going to be the one that I use up first. Now, if I find one around here, like people are finding them in Burlington and TJ Maxx, I'll probably get a couple more. But for the most part, the only ones I want repeats on is the regular one, the lavender one, this brown sugar, the calendula. I could stand 2 more of these and maybe another pomegranate. But I think this one and the pomegranate, and maybe that kiwi, is going to be what people use in the summer. But I really do like these a whole lot. I do. And I'm happy that they're still around. So that's all I got there. So now I'm going to share with you the soap. So there's another one of these. I'd rip it up, but both my hands are not free. So I got 2 of the berry waffle cones. And then I got a Beach Bliss, and I thought I got 2 of those, but I might not have. I got a Pineapple Prosecco, a Linen and Lavender, and I might repeat these, but I don't know. Definitely this one. My daughter loves any watermelon. So Coastal Watermelon. I got another Pink Petal Tea Cake because I knew I'd better. I got a crisp apple because this right here was free, and in the store they had the mint one in here, and it was so pretty, but I didn't want that one, so I got the green apple to go with this. I might get another one of these as a gift, but putting your green soap in there is so pretty. I got an oceanfront garden and a golden sands. I do want to try the endless weekend, but I'm not sure because I never really cared for it as a scent, but I'm thinking about trying the mist. And I do want to say with this one, I got this one. I had asked people because y'all know that I'm in Indiana area. And when I got this soap, I noticed that it was not at the sale price when I put the code in. And I checked around to make sure, because if it wasn't going to be a part of the sale, they would have either taken it off the site or put something up there. So I ended up calling customer service yesterday, who told me that they would refund me my money and they gave me free shipping for my order, which was the $5.99 back. But this was still the $7.50, and it didn't. So that's what made me ask if any of you have had that and you get your order and you notice that this is $7.50 and that it's not at the sale price, go ahead and call customer service. I put the information on Instagram because it should be on sale. And she said it was just a glitch that it wasn't coming off of there, but a lot of people might not have noticed it. If I wouldn't have been checking to see when my order was coming and saw that this still had that price, guys, I wouldn't have noticed it either. So that is it. Until the next time, everyone have a great day. Happy Mother's Day to everyone, whether you're a mother, an aunt, an uncle. If you take care of anybody, happy day to you.